Ladies and gentlemen, what's up YouTube? It's your boy Innuendo. If you don't get it, we in you win dough, but if you with it, when it's finished, in the end, you win dough, man. Let's go. Look, I'm back at it like a bad habit, another video for you guys. Listen, I'm actually probably going to be, today might be the last time I use this camera here. The reason for that is I feel like every single time the freaking camera decides it doesn't want to work, like it phase out of existence in the middle of recording. I'm like, I don't want that to be the thing. Like, I want to give y'all good quality. So I might end up going into my original thing, how I used to record videos using my phone camera, really good camera by the way, instead, and we might go from there. But for now, we're doing that. It just takes a little bit more editing with that, but we're going to do this regular, and then probably moving forward we'll do the other video, like the different format. But let's get it in. We're going to be checking out Eminem Houdini. It's actually next in the track list, and I want to kind of like give another perspective on it since we heard it when it first came out versus now. Like, is the song still hype? Is it still fire? I feel like I haven't been able to stop playing it, to be honest with you. So, but let's just dive right in. What the fuck?
Hey, Em, it's Paul.
It was trying to play. You got the Paul skit. The Paul thing in the beginning, real nice. I always thought that was real cool.
Hey, Em, it's Paul. I was listening to the album.
Good fucking luck. You're on your own. That was nice. And the guest is back. The guest is back. I'm gonna try my best not to rap the lyrics on the thing, but this song, I don't know what it is. It's just been like on repeat for a hot minute. The guess who's back, the reminiscent of the without me kind of thing or whatever, still classic, still kind of clever. I'm not gonna lie, I feel like Eminem does this kind of thing where he's like, he knows a formula, so he's gonna try to make it work. But for a comeback album or album talking about Slim Shady and stuff, he did a lot of the right, he planted a lot of the right seeds, I should say, when it came to this album. And this Houdini song was actually a good way to pump up the album a little bit. It's goofy, silly, and he had fun, and I definitely am excited for that.
Fuck, you're on your own.
Guess who's back? Back again. Shady's back, back. Tell a friend. Guess who's back? 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 Na 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 na. Well, look for the stalk from. Gonna be me never with a forked tongue, and it's sticking out, yeah, like a sore thumb, with a forehead that a ghoul haunts from. Well, look for the stork brown, little baby devil with the forked tongue, and it's sticking out, yeah, like a sore thumb, with a forehead that a grew horns from. His rhyme scheme, I like the stork brown, forked tongue, sore thumb, grew horns from. I like how he put those stuff together, and it's like he's trying to like introduce himself again, the white devil kind of like aspect. Look with the sword brum, little baby devil with the forked tongue. It's a little devil reference to whatever the case is, the grew the horns and all that stuff. Because they always try to say he's like the white, like white devil or whatever. That was always just kind of like a stigma they try to throw on him.
Well, look for the sword brum. Little baby devil with the forked tongue, and it's sticking out, yeah, like a sore thumb, with a forehead that a grew horns from. Still a white jerk, pulling up at a Chrysler with a sight verb, with a biker in a butt light shirt.
See, it's like, and I think, see, even though this is silly, he threw a lot of silly lines in here, he still technically put words really nice together. It just wasn't as chaotic as people normally hear, which I think why this song did so well. I think the beat was just goofy, and that's why people was like, I don't know. But you gotta hand it to him, and then kind of did his thing with this. That was like one of my favorite lines. Lyrical technician and electrician, y'all light work. Oh, I love that line. Y'all light work, and I don't gotta play pretend. It's you, I make believe, and you know I'm here to stay. Cause me, if I was to ever take a leave, it would be as friend to break a feed. If I was to ever take a leave, it would be aspirin to break a thief. Come on, man. That fire line. If I was the with the flex. And then, oh, and the line right before it, too, actually. And I don't gotta play pretend it's you, I make believe. The make believe play on words and play pretend it's you, I make believe. Like, I make you believe in this. I don't need to play pretend. I make you believe what I want you to believe. Like, come on now. Like, how he made everybody believe that the reverse theory of listening to the album in reverse was the correct order to listen to, and it wasn't. I'm just saying, you're wrong. But, okay. Everybody really thought they ate when they said that. Let's listen to it in reverse. No, it's not. Stop the madness. You thought you ate, but you didn't. And now I gotta play pretend it's you, I make believe. But you don't click up here to stay, cause me. If I was to ever take a leave, it would be aspirin to break a fee. If I was to ask for making the stallion, if she would collab with me, would I really have a shot at a feat? I don't know, but I'm glad to be back like that. Crazy. The Megan Thee Stallion line, in my original reaction video, I heard the line and I noticed it after the fact, but I never went back to clarify the whole Megan Thee Stallion getting shot in the foot by Tory Lanez kind of thing or whatever, and the double one, have a shot at a feat, like getting a feature with her, whatever the case is. I still feel like Megan Thee Stallion should do a collab with Eminem. That would be kind of different. I was hoping it would be something on the album after he kind of did that. That would have been like really nice. So that sucks. But yeah, I knew what I did. I just wasn't thinking about it at the time. And I had like recording and editing and stuff. I'm like, oh shoot, duh. If she would collab with me, did I really have a shot at a feat? I don't know, but I'm glad to be back. Like, I still feel like the hook of the bag bro and I'm back bro, bag bruh and bag bro, even though he says bruh and bro, almost similar. It's so weird, but I don't like that. I get he probably, I don't know if he didn't have too much to work with that, but I don't know. It just, I didn't like the chorus. I mean, I could sing the chorus all freaking day. It don't matter. It just doesn't sound right. It just doesn't sound right. Like abracadabra. I found my last trick. Just like that, and I'm back, bro. Now back in the days of old me, right around the time I became a dopey. Ate some codeine as a way of coping. Take the movie. Like, to start the verse like that. Now back in the days of old me, right around the time I became a dolphin, ace of Cody as a way of coping, case of OP, yes, ace of, like, bro, who, what? Like, in the old me, right around the time I became a dolphin, ate some codeine as a way of coping, taste of OP, hates case of OE. Like, bro, oh my god, it's just like he started the verse and like, okay. Old me, right around the time I became a dopey. Ace of Kobe, it's a way of coping. Ace of Opie, it's case of Opie. Turned me into smiley face emoji. My shit may not be age appropriate, but I will hit an 8-year-old in the face with a participation trophy. I don't know, some people was critiquing about that line right there. Okay, so the turn into smiley face emoji is like he took drugs and it made him happy all the time, basically. My shit may not be age appropriate. Smiley face emoji, age appropriate. He was rhyming the words like that, but age appropriate. I know some people critiqued about how it's broken down, whatever the case is, but Eminem does that. It's like I think he's like a choppy kind of thing he does or whatever, but I actually am not mad because he figured out a way to fit the word and then use the next part of the word to start the next sentence. Eight, but I will hit an eight. Like, and then that word rhymes too, so age appropriate, but I will hit an 8. Age appropriate, but I will hit an 8-year-old in the face with a participation trophy. Like, come on, age appropriate, participation trophy. The whole entire thing rhymes, which is nice, but people didn't get that, so. With a participation trophy, I have zero doubts that this whole world's about to turn into some Girl Scouts. That censorship girls out. Set me down. So when I started it. The freaking, first of all, throwing a participation trophy at somebody's crazy, but I feel like everybody's getting a participation trophy now. It's like they just handing them out. It don't even matter no more.
This verse, it did start off lighthearted at first, but it feels like I'm targeted. Mind-boggling how my profit is skyrocketed. Look what I pocketed. Yeah, the shit is just like y'all have been. Light jogging in. I've been running at full speed, and that's why I'm ahead like my noggin. In. Time to fight y'all in. When you debate who the best, but I'll sound white chalk and win. I step up to that mic cock it then. Oh my god, attack chicken out again.
And pretty much tell me some. It's like y'all been doing like jogging and I've been running full speed. Like I've been kind of like going as fast as I can, doing the best I can. Y'all been kind of just thinking you chilling, but it's like you're not even on my level, basically. And then like I like that. And the fight y'all get in, we need to debate who's the best. But I'm white chalking it. Basically, like you're talking about who you think the best is or whatever. And it's like clearly it's me. Basically. I'm still not a fan of that hook, I'm not gonna lie.
Break it down.
Sometimes I wonder what the old me say, if what?
If he could see the way shit is too late, he'd probably say that.
Also too, Eminem actually, cause he did a lot of the stunts and everything in the video, even the Slim Shady parts, but they use a de-age AI filter, whatever the freak, on Eminem to make him look like his younger self, but he did a lot of that stuff himself. And the same for the actual, like, Slim Shady back in the day voice was an AI filter voice changer, whatever the hell kind of thing.
That everything is gay. What's my name? What's my name? How many little kids feel when I
act like me?
I'm a bigger prick than
Kekt ID.
And that's why these.
I feel like, and then this part right here, I feel like was the best part of the third verse for the most part, starting out. I'm not a big fan of the preceding verse, the words and verses coming in after.
Words thing just like you were being attacked by bees in the coop, leaning back my seat. Open R. Kelly's favorite group, the black guy bees.
That was kind of like in the middle for me.
In my Air Max 90s, white tees, walking parental advisory. My transgender cat Siamese.
And then you get to this.
Black but ex-Chinese. Like a motherfucking hacky sack I treat. Why? The whole world cause I got it at my feet.
So it was just like, it was just flip-flopping of every other bar was nice, and then the ones in between was just a throwaway line. How can I explain to you that even myself I'm a danger to? I hop on tracks like a kangaroo and say a few things for you or two to anger you.
Even myself I'm a danger to. I hop on tracks like a kangaroo and say a few things or two to anger you. If I thought that, if I think that shit, I'ma say that shit. Cancel me, what? Okay, that's
if I think that shit, I'ma say that shit. I fucks with that.
Yeah, cancel me, what? Okay, that's it. Go ahead, Paul, quit. Snake ass prick, you nail cross dresser, fake ass bitch. And I'll probably get shit for that. Why? But you can all suck my dick in fact. Fuck them, fuck Dre, fuck Jimmy, fuck me, fuck you. Fuck my own kids, they're brats.
Fuck them!
Niggas screw off,
yeah.
Them and you are.
Which was still wilder shit that he said fuck his own kids, the brats.
Biggest group off, them and you off, you two off, got two balls, biggest group paws. What you thought you saw, ain't what you saw, cause you're never gonna see me. Caught sleeping, see the kidnapping, never did happen. Like Sherry Papini, Harry Houdini, I vanish into the thin air as I'm leaving like
that. And the ending, how he ended it was nice, Sherry Papini disappearing, or whatever, faking her kidnapping, you never see the kidnapping. The double was very, very clever. I'm not gonna hold you. But overall, like aside from maybe like the chorus and a couple lines, the intro in the first and second verse was really like not that bad. It was pretty good. The third verse was like a back and forth, but it was proceeding to end the song. And I'm actually not mad because I bumping the whole song or just kind of jamming. You pretty much end up rapping and singing the whole thing anyway. So the hook is kind of like the hit or miss kind of thing for me, but it's not too repetitive to drag you away. So yeah, but if you guys enjoyed this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, baby. Share with your friends and put your videos out every single week. Pretty much every single day, roads were 1,000. Let's get it in, man. If you got two ears, go ahead and subscribe. If you're new, check out the channel. Put down in the comment section below what you guys want to see next. Other than that, I gotta go. I'll catch you guys in the next video for sure. And we'll probably be checking out some more Eminem. We're gonna just go straight down the track list. But listening on a second take, I still feel like it's worth the hype. I just feel like it has fans split because people don't know what kind of what they really want from Eminem, and you hear an old school version, you're like, that's Eminem trying to be his old son. So give the man a break. This song is not bad. A lot of people just want to hear Eminem just rap and spit his bars. Not rap fast, but just rap and spit his bars and do his thing. So I get it. They hear a silly song and they're like, what is this? But to me, I like the silly song. So let's go. But other than that, I'll catch you guys in the next one, man. Peace out, love you, bye, and all that fun jizz. But yeah, Eminem Houdini. Who would have known?